If you're using pages for your book or document, you might be referencing a lot of terms in it that some of your readers might not be familiar with, and you want to make it as easy as possible for them to find out the definitions. So instead of forcing them to go to Google to search for them, you can put together a glossary very easily in pages and put it at the end of your document or book, and they can reference it. And there's two different ways of doing so. I'll show you the one that I prefer is with the use of a table, and then the second method, which is basically using plain text. So let's get started. So I have a sample document here, and I'm using some information from Wikipedia on Isaac Newton. And there's a lot of terms, you know, references to science, to physics, and so on. And not all of these might be familiar terms to the readers, so it's good to put the glossary at the end. So I'm going to the end, and you can start from scratch. I'm just going to start on this page, but I already have some terms that I put together in Excel, so I'm just going to copy this, do Command C, copy, go to pages, and I'm going to do Command V to paste it. You can see that it looks very much like a table, and I don't want that. Now I'm going to just change the view to documents so there's no distractions. I can work on formatting this so it looks much better. So the first thing you do, you want to select it. Once you select it, then you see the rows and the columns at the top, and you have that circle in the upper left corner. If you click on it, that's when you can move the table and do a lot of things with it. Once I click on that, I can see that under format on the right, I have all these options. So the first thing that I like to do is basically remove any type of line. So I don't want any lines. And sometimes you might find it in different places. I also want to change the alternating row color so there's no, it doesn't look like a table basically, because with those rows being highlighted, you can tell it's a table. And then I'm going to go to cell, and under border, you might have to rotate through all these options because right now it shows no border. But if I click on this option, I see that there is border. So then I have to go through them and make sure to check that there's no border anywhere else. Okay, and that's no border. Now I'm just going to unclick. Okay, it still looks like a table. I'm going to select one more time, and now I want to change the text. So this text is very large and it's a reference, so you definitely don't need it so big. I'm going to change the font to 10, and I also want to change the width of this column. So if I click on the table, I can just select the column and make it more narrow. And the definitions can be wider, but the terms don't need to. Now, the reason why I like using the table is not only the formatting is quicker because I can format this whole column with all the terms at once, but also what I really like is if you select your column and you click that arrow down, you have this option to sort ascending or descending. And this is really helpful, especially if you're just like drafting your document, your book, putting in the terms. You don't have to worry about if you're putting it in the right order. You can sort it later. And so if I sort this right now, what will happen? If I sort ascending, look what happened. The term and definition got sorted as well. So I'm going to undo. Because what you have to do, if you have title for your terms and definition or whatever you have there at the top of your glossary, you want to make sure you define this as header row. So I'm going to convert to header row. And now I'm going to also say, because now if I sort it, let me show you, it's not going to sort the header as well. But the additional benefit is that I can also make this repeat at each of the pages as long as my glossary is running. So I can select that row and click on the arrow and say repeat header row on each page. And now you can see that it's repeating on each of the pages where my glossary is. And now I want to actually the terms be a little bit larger. So maybe I'll do 11. And I also want to make it bold. So make it bold for all the terms. Now, I also like to change the alignment. I'm going to go to text under format, and now I want to align to the right. So this already looks better. Now, this is an alignment that's horizontal. It tells you if it's left, center, right, but there's also alignment that goes vertically. And I would like to actually make sure that they align correctly because I can see that these words are centered within the cell. So I want to just put it at the top so they align nicer, and I like that. And I like how this looks much better. Now what I also like to do, select my table and go to layout and also add a little bit of cushion between one of the definition and the other. So you can see that it's not a continuous, there's a little bit of spacing in between. Now I can also select this table and go to table and select title. And this would add the title, and I could say glossary here. Now I actually prefer not putting the glossary title in the table, but having it outside and moving my table next to the title. Is the reason why is because if you have table of content, then you won't be able to link to the title of the table. So let me change also the title color. So if I go to title style, I'm going to change this color to maybe blue, like this. And now what I also like to do is select this column and right click, and I want to add a column before, and I don't need it this so wide, but I would like to have, which I find helpful, is where the terms change from A's to B's to C's and so on. So it's easy as a reference for a reader to reference it. Okay, where's my elasticity? I can easily find it where I can just browse through the letter. So I like to take what I have here as my title and go to the first letter, and I'm going to change it to A. And then I'm going to do the same for the rest. Now you want to make sure you do this at the very end, because if there's going to be any sorting, it can mess up, and you want to make sure that you're going to fix it afterwards. So you want to remember that. And it just might take a bit at the first time you're doing it, but it really looks nice. So I like to put that 3 minutes that it takes to do this. And finally, one more thing I like to do is actually select this column. I would like to have like a light dashed line on the right. So I have to select cell. Now I have to select where I want to add that border. And I'm going to say I want to have this dashed line. And I'm going to usually use the same color that I'm using as an accent. And you can make it maybe 1 point so you can so slightly see it. And here you go. And here's a great looking glossary as a table in Pages. So the second way to do the glossaries in Pages is basic, just as plain text. So I'm going to go to my Excel table again, copy this over and go to Pages. Now, if I paste it again, it's going to be a table. So I don't like that. I need to convert it to text. So the walk around it is do the insert the text box and paste the table here. And so once I paste it, I'm going to do copy again, and I'm going to paste it outside. And now you can see that it's pasted as text. So that's great. So now we're going to go to the top of it, and I'm going to actually select all of it to the end. And I want to change the text size first, maybe just make it century Gothic, and I'm going to change it to size 9. And I'm going to remove this term and definition because it was from the table. Now, what I like to do is, now, you know, it's very hard to read. And even if we do the terms, we do it bold and maybe change the color and maybe increase 1 point larger, it's still not going to look great. So what I still like to do is actually do shift command, arrow down, select it all. And I want to go to layout, and instead of the one column, I want to make it 2 columns. And the 2 columns looks much better. It's much better use of the space. And once I have it, all I'm going to do right now is actually select the term, do Option Command C. So I'm copying the style, not the words, and then go through each of them and do Option Command V and paste the formatting. So all of this will look the same. So we're just going to do that right. And right now you can see what's happening, that some of these, I'm getting some of these orphans, which basically it's like the term and then the definition are on 2 different pages. And I'll show you how to fix that once we finish with our formatting. And I'm not going to go through all of these pages. I'm just going to remove them so we can just focus on how to do it versus of doing busy work. Okay, so this is how it looks right now. And the second thing I want to do is also maybe add where the letters are changing, when it's A's, B's, and so on, so it's easy to tell. And maybe I'm going to do this in a different color, not because too much blue is also not really good. So I'm just going to do actually change this color to black and increase the size to 11 point. And I'm just going to paste this where the alphabet changes, where the letters are changing. So you want to do this first before you start dealing with the orphans, because if you deal with the orphans and you add these letters, then it will mess up everything again. That's why I also like using tables better. It's just easier to format some of this stuff, like versus pasting, you know, the format for your term. For each of the words, you can just select a column and format it. And lay down, you know, no one can tell when you have that book that this is a table. It's kind of disguised. So now we have this. So what I also like to do now is try to fix this orphan situation when I have here elasticity. The term is on this page, but the definition on this one. So what you want to do is select the term and you want to go to more under format and say keep with next paragraph. And you want to just fix it wherever you see it. Here's another one like that. I'm going to select it and then say keep with next. And that fixes the problem. And here we go. So we have the two different types of glossaries, one as a table and one as a text. And this is super helpful for your readers. If they don't understand all the terms that are used in your book or your document, they can just reference it and they don't have to go research on Google what it means. So thanks so much for watching.